तीव्र काम असि यथा तव काम तथा तव निश्चय
यथा तव काम तथा तव निश्चय यथा तव निश्चय तथा तव कर्म यथा तव कर्म तथैव तव भाग्य
ब्रह्मादि
विनायक
মহতে মোরে মহন মুহিলি
মায়দন্ত মলে বন্দনা মদগাদকেরে ಮಾಯದಂತ ಮಳೆ ಬಂದಣ್ಣ ಮದಗಾದಕ್ಕೆರೆಗೆ ಅಂಗೈಯಷ್ಟು ಮೋಡನಾಗಿ ಭೂಮಿ ತುಗದ ಗಾಳಿ ಬಿಸಿ ಹುಡುಗಿ ಗೂಡಾಗಿ ಚಲ್ಲಿದಳೋ ಮಾಯದಂತ ಮಳೆ ಬಂತಣ್ಣ ಮದಗಾದಕ್ಕೆರೆ ಮದಗಾದಕ್ಕೆರೆ ಓಂ ಮದಗಾದಕ್ಕೆರೆ
ರಬ್ಬ ಮೇರೆಯಾ
रब मेरे आ, रब मेरे आ, रब मेरे आ।
Plantation actually is from 1935 onwards. It was taken over by my grandfather. The area was cleared and then it was planted. Then my father came back onto this estate. He found some of the best plant material and he grew it on a small area, about 2 acres. Then the best plants were kept on it, the rest of the plants were removed. And these plants were replanted in that area. And again these plants were grown. And the best of these coffees were kept, and again the rest of the coffees were removed. Third generation of coffees that you're actually finding over here, that has been selectively bred on the estate. It is not a research program or anything else, it is a farmer who's actually brought this coffee, what he thinks is the best coffee brought forward. It is a jungle litter that is actually coffee was always grown under wild areas, and now we have cleared jungle and made plantations. We find that as many animals come in, you see, they are going to leave behind their trail, droppings, certain things. They are going to enrich the soil. And this enrichment of the soil is different. So it's going to, we are trying to bring back to the original jungle soil. If the bears, they come in at night, and there for the fruit trees, we have these wild fruit trees over here. It's unpaid security for us. Look at the papaya. We have a lot of papaya trees on the estate. We don't market the papayas, it's only meant for the birds. So we have a lot of the birds coming in over here that feed on these papaya trees. And we let our labor pick as many as they want. So they've reached a stage where they don't want to pick anymore. They've had their fill. So they leave it to the birds to feed on. Indian coffee is one thing is eco-friendly. There's nowhere in the world that you get a coffee that is so eco-friendly, grown under the shade of so many different jungle trees. Everywhere else in the world it is more sun-grown than shade-grown. And in India what happens is that we sacrifice quantity for quality. We have the quality over here because shade-grown coffee does not yield as much as the sun-grown coffee. Indian coffee is well looked after. It is natured from the time of picking till the time it goes into your hulling. It is looked after well, natured well, and more than anything else, it is the livelihood of so many people. It's not one estate or one grower, one manager or one owner. It is the whole community or a whole group of people who are working at it. All these people have all come back. They come for the season, they all come here. They are working on the estate. This boy over here who is the masri now, he's been with me for the past, 30 years. He grew up over, his father joined in over here. He grew up over here with us. Now he's, his children are schooling, they're all in high school, and one boy is doing his first PUC, but he's on the estate. So it's more like, you're trying to have a family over here. These are all traps for the insects. You do it organically, you don't have pesticide spray. There is this fruit tree which I'll show you now. It's called Palapandu. The inside of this fruit has got a lot of gum, like your jackfruit gum. And that eaten is supposed to deworm the children. It is also a delicacy of a lot of the spotted deer and the barking deer. So they come in a lot to eat this this fruit. That's a clear top. You see, there are these holes on these leaves which have specifically been eaten by grasshoppers. Now if a grasshopper can find this leaf tasty, then it is sure telling you that the whole area is not toxic. The ant is over here. See, the anthills, actually most people associate it as a negative thing, like white ants and termites. But these anthills over here, actually what they do is they actually tell us what is under the soil. It's actually bringing out the soil from under the surface of the soil to show you how fertile the soil is outside. You see this dead tree. Now this dead tree is trying to tell you that it is decomposing back to nature. Become soil again, and all the nutrients that it has taken for its growth is giving back to soil. We have a very good thing like coffee board over here, which gives us a lot of information. Like, they give us soil analysis, they give us leaf analysis. And with these analysis and support, we are able to understand what the buyer wants. Indian Robustas are always high grown here in India. That is grown above the altitude of 1,500 feet. Right now we are at 3,000 feet above sea level. And most places, Robusta coffee is not grown at 3,000 feet above sea level. So one of the strong points of the Indian Robusta is shade grown, high elevation coffee. Indian coffee is such a lovely product because the more you look after it, the better it becomes. From one coffee bean, by carefully picking it, curing it, processing it, storing it, and finally getting it to the consumer, you can get the product into such a beautiful flavors. Please come home and have a cup of coffee.
Tadim, tarikiri kita tadim, 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 tad